The Bible says, when he shall appear, we shall be like him. However, for us to be like him then, we must be like him now. Do you want to be like Jesus Christ? If so, listen to this devotional, written by Ellen G. White. To be like Jesus, it's time to give up health-destroying indulgences. October 3rd. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your paths. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6. There is a message regarding health reform to be borne in every church. There is a work to be done in every school. Neither principal nor teachers should be entrusted with the education of the youth until they have practical knowledge of this subject. Some have felt at liberty to criticize and question and find fault with health reform principles of which they knew little by experience. They should stand shoulder to shoulder, heart to heart, with those who are working in right lines. The subject of health reform has been presented in the churches, but the light has not been heartily received. The selfish, health-destroying indulgences of men and women have counteracted the influence of the message that is to prepare a people for the great day of God. If the churches expect strength, they must live the truth which God has given them. If the members of our churches disregard the light on this subject, they will reap the sure result in both spiritual and physical degeneracy. And the influence of these older church members will leaven those newly come to the faith. The Lord does not now work to bring many souls into the truth because of the church members who have never been converted and those who were once converted but who have backslidden. What influence would these unconsecrated members have on new converts? Would they not make of no effect the God-given message which His people are to bear? Let all examine their own practices to see if they are not indulging in that which is a positive injury to them. Let them dispense with every unhealthful gratification in eating and drinking. Some go to distant countries to seek a better climate, but wherever they may be, the stomach creates for them a malarious atmosphere. They bring upon themselves suffering that no one can alleviate. Let them bring their daily practice into harmony with nature's laws, and by doing as well as believing, an atmosphere may be created about both soul and body that will be a savor of life unto life. Testimonies for the Church, Volume 6, page 370 and 371. Thank you so much for listening to this devotional. Hope to see you tomorrow for another devotion of the day.